If we're talking about, mitigating climate change and reducing carbon footprints, there are actually many things people can do, like retrofitting their homes and insulating their homes to, improve energy efficiency, also reduce their energy costs ultimately. They can bring in solar energy. They can obviously switch, their sort of modes of transportation. And what we found is that what really works with people is if they're working together on doing all of these kinds of things to get ready for climate change and to reduce their carbon footprints. So one example is the small community of Eagle Island. It's about 30 homes on a little island very close to West Vancouver. And 28 or 29 of those homes have retrofitted their properties, reduced their carbon footprints. And it was all just by sort of getting together and helping each other and having lots of parties and having lots of fun. But when everybody sees what everybody else is doing, it becomes much easier to do these things. So a lot of it has to do with this sort of pressure or support for each other at a community scale. And at Eagle Island, that was very successful, and it's become a model for other neighborhoods in the Vancouver area as well. One of the things they did, and one of the things that we're very interested in, is helping those processes by using these visual tools. In their case, they use thermal imaging, infrared pictures of people's homes. And when you do that, it becomes so obvious where you're losing energy and you're losing money. And it was a big incentive, along with all this kind of social support that the neighbors gave, to just get your home done, and most people did it. So it is feasible to do these things, just takes more collective action.